Hi, I'm Matt Paxton, and I'm an extreme cleaning specialist. Tonight on Cosmic Hoarders, we're going to meet the biggest hoarder in the solar system, the planet Earth.
Hi, Matt.
Now, Earth, you've called us here today because of all the space junk in orbit around you. Maybe you could tell me how it is that you've accumulated all this stuff.
Well, it started in 1957 when humans began launching things into orbit around me. At first, it wasn't a problem because those early satellites were in low orbits, so the drag from my atmosphere would slow them down and they'd fall back and burn up before they hit the ground. But then humans started launching bigger and bigger things into higher orbits where the drag was so low that I could no longer keep up with bringing them down anymore. So you see, it really isn't my fault that the orbit is so cluttered. It's because the humans put all that stuff up there.
Well, I realize that you didn't put the stuff here in the first place. But can't you see that by keeping it all, you've created a dangerous situation? The orbiting debris could damage the International Space Station. And all those little bits and pieces of junk can knock out useful satellites, making more trash in space.
I know. I don't want to harm my humans with all this junk. I love my humans. They're what make me unique. But I can't just part with this stuff. And besides, it's not all trash. There's that space station, and the GPS satellites that you're all so fond of, and the weather station, the satellite TV, and the radio that you just can't seem to live without.
Okay. Slow down. Take a deep breath. I'm not asking you to get rid of everything, just the things that are dangerous and no longer useful. And I'm here to help you sort through all of it. I've got these boxes to get us started. One for things you want to keep, and one for the trash. Let's start with some big items first, so we can make some room to work with. The biggest by far is the International Space Station. That goes in the keep box, right?
Oh, yes. I wouldn't want to get rid of that.
Now we've got some old things that no longer work, like Vanguard 1 here. It was launched in 1958 and hasn't worked since 1964. Surely we can get rid of that.
But I like it. It's been going around longer than anything up here. It's cute. And I might figure out how to fix it one day.
But you haven't fixed it in almost 50 years. It's garbage. And remember, we're doing this for the safety of humans.
All right, you can throw it away.
Now we're making some progress. I'm proud of you for getting rid of that satellite that you've been holding on to for so long. That was a big decision. Now let's try to move faster. What about all these nuts and bolts and things like tools and cameras that have been lost by astronauts? Trash, right?
Yeah, I guess that stuff is pretty useless, so it's trash.
Oh man, here's the problem. These old Soviet satellites launched in the 1970s for an ocean reconnaissance program? These things have nuclear reactors on board. We've got to get rid of them before there's a radiation leak.
Yeah, I can see how that might be dangerous. I guess it's trash.
I knew this was going to be a tough job, but I didn't expect radiation hazards.
You've only been throwing things away. Can't I keep anything?
Of course you can keep some things that are still useful, like this weather station, and this communication satellite, and this GPS satellite, and the Hubble Space Telescope. But you shouldn't keep all these spent rocket stages, dead satellites, and this glove lost by astronaut Ed White back in 1960.
Wow, I didn't realize how much things had piled up.
Well, humans have been launching this stuff for over 50 years, and it's starting to become a real problem. 5 times over the last 3 years, the International Space Station has had to perform maneuvers to avoid colliding with space junk. And your gravity, Earth, holds this debris in orbit for a long, long time. If a piece of space junk is orbiting high enough to avoid atmospheric drag, then it could be hundreds or even thousands of years before other forces bring it back down to the ground.
So, you see why it's so hard for me to get rid of things. I can't be expected to disobey the law of gravity. And you humans better watch out, because you're sending your space junk to other planets, too. You got junk in orbit around Venus, Mercury, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. Someday, we're going to get together and get you for this.
Hold on. I thought you said you loved your humans. And besides, we're just curious creatures, and the best way to learn about these other planets is to send our spacecraft.
Oh, you're right. I do love you all. And you sure are a curious lot. Thanks for helping me clean up my space, Matt. You're my new favorite human.
Thanks, Earth. You're my favorite planet. I love you, too. I'm glad I could help. Well, that's another planet cleaned up on Cosmic Hoarders. Tune in next week when we'll help Saturn get rid of a whole ring of debris. Until next time, I'm the clutter cleaner, Matt Paxton, reminding you to clean up your space.